What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be modeling this really cool building that has kind of an integrated roof with a tree that's part of the landscape. Now I've actually seen this project on another YouTube channel. His name is David Tomic. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly. I think that's that he's or his family is from Serbia or somewhere around, because that's a really common name here. But anyways, he has this channel that's dedicated, I think, to ARCHICAD and just architecture in general, and he has a tutorial on how to model this cool building in ARCHICAD. And I saw that and I thought, well, you can do that in Revit and you can do that better in Revit, so why would you use ARCHICAD if you can use Revit, which is better? So that's how I got to this tutorial here. So anyways, that's what we're doing today. Now before I jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find some of my Revit courses, well, all of my Revit courses. There is over 136 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. You can find courses ranging from many different topics for beginners, intermediate, as well as advanced level users. Also there you can find some ready to go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families. So for example, one of those families or family packs is a tree family pack, and one of those trees we can use in this particular video to have that kind of a landscape tree for our building. And then also on my website you can find a plugin, which is really interesting. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit, and here we are. So now what I'm going to be doing is just go here to Models, go to New, and then here I'm just going to be using my custom Balkan Architect template. So as I said, if you want to check out my templates, you can find them on my website. I'm also going to include a quick link up in the cards above. So anyways, let's now click OK and let's let Revit start up. Now what we can do is just go here to the massing inside, and what you want to do is turn on show mass. So we're going to be building this as a mass, and you want to turn on the visibility of massing first, and then you can go to in place mass. Here we can name it. I'm just going to leave it as mass 1 because I don't really care for the name. And now let's get started. So first we want to have a surface on which we can host a line that's going to give us the initial shape of the roof. So for that you want to go here to the reference plane, RP is the shortcut, and then you just want to have like one horizontal line here, and then you just click to name, and then you can name it. So I can call this one ref1, for example, for reference plane 1, and then just hit the escape key a couple of times. Now once we have done this, now we know that on this reference plane we can host our geometry. So I can simply now go to my south elevation, and then here I can create that geometry. Let's pick a plane, which is that reference plane ref1. Okay, click OK, and then I can just come in here, and I'm just going to click a little bit above this level, and then let's go, I don't know, something like 15 meters, something like that, and then let's just switch to the arc and then go down at a 45 degree angle, giving us like a perfect 90 degree arc here. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and there we go. So we have our initial geometry for the shape of the roof. Now we can just jump into the 3D view. This is what we have. Now we can select that. We can go to create form. So you just click here and it's going to create form just like that. Now you want to extend this a little bit. Currently it's at 6 meters. I actually want it to be at 9, so I'm just going to type in 9 there. Now it might do this. See how it's weird? So you can just select this point and then you can move it until it snaps like that. And also let's switch this quickly to hidden line. There we go. And now as you can see, we have that correct shape. Okay, moving forward, I'm just going to open up the site plan so I can see this thing from kind of from top on the top, and then let's make that opening here for that kind of vertical tree integration part. So for that, I'm simply going to go here to the circle tool. For the reference plane, we can leave it at level 1. That's perfectly fine. You want to come in here on this edge, click, and then extend by one, let's go with 2.5 meters, just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now if I go to the 3D view, Oh, because I've clicked on this, it kind of hosted that circle there. That's perfectly fine. So now you just want to go to create form, but instead of clicking on create form, expand the drop menu and then click on void form. So when it creates that cylinder, you will see that it's just going to generate a void inside of this shape. It's kind of like somebody kind of ate this part or bit it out. So anyways, let's now continue. So what you want to do now is go back to the site plan. And now we need an additional reference plane. So you go here to reference plane. Then I'm just going to click here on this midpoint, stretch it out, and then click to name. And let's call this one the ref 2 reference plane. Okay, now we can go to this elevation here, which is on the east. So that's the east elevation. Here we have that reference plane, this is the original one. So if I just go back here to site, actually I want to mark out this spot here. So I can again go to reference plane and then just click here and then extend it like that. Now this one we don't really need to name because we just wanted to kind of mark that particular spot. Okay, so once we have this all laid out, I can go back here and go to arc. For the reference plane, choose ref 2, click OK. And now if I go from here, and then let's go at, I don't know, like 1.6, just like so. And then we can go up by additional, I don't know, like 4 meters. Oops, not an arc. I wanted a line. Okay. Something like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times. And now if we go back to the 3D view, this is what we have. So now if you just select this thing, hold the control key, see how the cursor has that little plus icon? Now we can come here, and as you can see, it's not going to allow us just to get the arc. So you want to hover over it, hit the tab key once or twice or three times in this case. Now it's just highlighted. I haven't selected it. Now you want to hold the control key, click to select, and now if you go to create form, it's going to give us that kind of funnel shape for our tree. And this is exactly what we wanted to see. So once we have all of this done, and I think this is really enough from the massing environment, so we can just go here to finish mass, and it's done. And now it's time to turn this into actual 3D Revit geometry. Now, what you want to do for that is, again, go here to massing insight, and then here we have a small issue. When it comes to placing either roofs or walls, Revit is not going to want to place walls horizontally, but it's not going to want to place roofs vertically. So that's just one of the things that kind of things that Revit has. So what I like to do is just go here to the wall tool first. Let's pick out, let's go with this 400 millimeter wall. And then you want to select this part, and then this part as well. If you try to select this horizontal part, as you can see, walls don't like to be horizontal, so we cannot use walls there. However, we couldn't use roofs here because roofs don't want to be vertical. So we have to create kind of a combination of walls and roofs. Okay, so once we have this, let's see. Yeah, if I just hit the escape key a couple of times, there we go. Now I can switch to roof. I have a 400 millimeter roof, and then I can just select this shape here and click create roof, and then this is what we have, and it looks perfectly fine. Okay, now we can check off show mass, and let's see, for shaded, it's going to look a little bit better. Now if you go to the modify tab and if you go to join geometry, it is going to want to join these usually, but even though you've joined this geometry, it's not going to get rid of these lines here. Now, I don't like those lines, even in this hidden line view style. Obviously, they're not going to be there in realistic. If you switch this to, let's see, if you turn off show lines, they're not going to be there. But actually, I don't like to see them in the hidden line view as well. So what I like to do is go here to the view panel, go to line work, and then just switch this to invisible lines. And then you can just click on the lines that you don't want to show, like this one here, that one there. Okay, perfect. This one here, here, here. So it's just a little bit of back and forth. And keep in mind that this is kind of view specific. So if you do this in one view, if you create another view, you have to do this all over again. So just keep that in mind. And then on the bottom, we have just this one a couple of times and this one. And there we go. I think now it looks a lot more elegant this way. And now to complete this, we can just add some walls, things like that. So I'm just going to do that real quick. And then we're going to add a tree and kind of complete this thing. And as you can see, I have kind of completed this a little bit, just adding some additional walls, a curtain wall here, and a floor. And as I said, let's add that tree from the tree family pack. If you want to get the family pack, I'm going to include it up in the cards above. But for now, let's just place that tree. So I'm just going to place it like this. Now, these trees come in multiple options. This particular one that I'm using is a scalable tree, which means that I can just come in here and instead of having this at 3 meters tall, I can say I want it at 9 meters and hit apply, and it's going to be 9 meters tall. And then I can just come in here and use the arrow keys to kind of nudge it in place a little bit. And once I'm happy with the positioning, there we go. So I think this looks really, really good. I really like the way that this has had turned out. So there you go. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have learned something new. I hope you like this building. And if you want to get this project file of this building, you can find it on my Patreon page, which I'm going to include in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.